Evaporation is the change in phase from liquid to gas. Condensation is the change in phase from gas to liquid. Evaporation and condensation are examples of physical processes because intermolecular forces are broken or formed in these processes. And so the substance is not changed into a different substance through the change. Instead, the particles of the substance are simply moved closer or further apart from one another. During evaporation, the intermolecular forces between particles in the liquid phase are broken, changing the particles into the gaseous phase. Only particles with sufficient kinetic energy are able to move quickly enough to break the intermolecular forces which hold them to other molecules. Temperature is a measure of average kinetic energy. Even at very cold temperatures, there are at least a few particles which have sufficient kinetic energy to allow evaporation at the surface of the liquid. Once these particles have changed into a gas, also called a vapor, they exert a pressure which is called vapor pressure. Evaporation happens at all temperatures at the surface of the liquid. But at a certain temperature, evaporation happens within the liquid, causing large bubbles of vapor to rise and explode at the surface. We call this boiling. What's going on during boiling, and why does it only happen at one particular temperature, called the boiling point, for a certain pressure? At any temperature, some of the faster-moving particles within the body of the liquid will try to break their intermolecular bonds and so vaporize. However, at temperatures below boiling point, there are not many particles with enough kinetic energy to be able to do this, and so the vapor pressure that they exert in a little bubble that they form is so weak that atmospheric pressure squashes the bubble before it can even form, forcing the particles back into the liquid phase. As temperature is increased, a greater proportion of particles have enough kinetic energy to be able to break the intermolecular bonds, keeping them in the liquid phase. Therefore, the vapor pressure that they can exert increases. When the vapor pressure they exert equals atmospheric pressure can no longer squash a bubble of vapor formed inside the liquid. So the bubble can form, and that is when boiling happens. So boiling happens when the vapor pressure of a substance equals the atmospheric pressure exerted on the substance. And that happens at a certain temperature, which is called the boiling point. The vapor pressure that a substance exerts and the temperature at which boiling occurs depends on the strength of the intermolecular bonds. So in other words, the strength of the intermolecular forces determines how much energy you have to add to the substance for those particles to have enough kinetic energy so that they will break their intermolecular forces.
And before we go, have you already liked? Have you subscribed? Have you left me a comment? And please go and visit my website. You'll find a lot of resources there, and they're categorized in a way that will make it very easy for you to find what you need. Until we meet again, learn science!